often wonder if roses grow in heaven. If they do, I'll ask my God to hand a few to you and tell you that I miss you. I miss the sound of your voice, the wisdom of your advice, the stories of your life, and the magic in your presence, and nothing ever could fulfill the void that your absence has created in my heart. I want him to tell you that when my heart refuses to believe your absence, I cope by thinking that maybe you're on a long holiday and I'll be seeing you very soon. Missing someone happens in everyday life, so I try to fit that grief into that familiar feeling. The reality is too big, too real. I often feel that a lot of me has witnessed an inescapable change. I refrain from talking to people, maybe because they ask me to move on. But deep down, I know they're asking me to stop cribbing about the same thing again and again. But I want to keep talking about you. I want to keep talking about the dawn-like smile. I don't want to lose on the memories of you. They're the only thing I have of you now. I live on them. Or maybe because they ask me to be strong when I cry. I can't be strong. There's no way. All I can do is to sob in the pillow, cry in the shower, and pray to not let it consume me. Or maybe because I can't understand how everyone carries on with their life. How do the birds continue to chirp? My sun did not rise once since the day you were gone. The birds never chirped and the days never passed. I'm just moving into a new calendar month that you will never be a part of. Your death wasn't a moment. It wasn't a phase in my life. It's a point when my life stood still. When time froze, it marked my life. From then onwards, time will only be divided into two parts. Before your death and after your death. There are no happy and sad phases anymore. They're simply phases that begin with the top. What if you were here to witness this? My dog often barks at the sky. I wonder if he's waving a hello to the dog or angels guarding you in heaven. I often find comfort in gazing the vastness of the sky. The sky reminds me that it's just a layer that separates you and me, and one day I'll meet you beyond that layer, beyond the realms of pain and suffering. And then maybe I could teach you the correct pronunciation of the word koi, or maybe we could just take a stroll down the streets of heaven looking for your favorite jalebis, thin, crisp, made in pure ghee jalebis. Thank you.